Hi there, what's going on? In this video, I'm going to share with you an amazing and powerful software which is totally free. I will share with you where to download the software and demonstrate to you how to use it to make videos with some visual effects. I just want to inform that this video is released together with another video of mine. Be sure to check out the video because in that video, I'll be sharing with you where you can download all the free and high quality stock footages that can be used together with this free video editing software to instantly improve your video quality. Notice how many times I mentioned the word free? Yes, it is totally free. It is a step-by-step kind of tutorial. By the end of the session, you should be able to pick up some basic video editing techniques and skills that will help you a long way. You should be able to make video like this.
How do you know you're not looking at her?
I've also listed all the topics in this video down in the links below, so that at any point in time, if you feel like jumping straight to a particular topic, please feel free to do so by clicking the links below. Without further ado, let's get started. Okay, first thing first, go to Google, type in Hitfilm Express. Go to the FX Home webpage. Click this button here, download Hitfilm Express. And at first it may appear confusing because it says 19 USD, but fret not. Pull this face icon here all the way to the left and it now shows 0 USD. Then you press download. Right, fill in all your particulars here on the left hand side and then make sure you fill in your email address correctly because that's where they're going to send the download link to you. After that, press the button on the right side, send me the express download. Okay, once you have downloaded it, just open it up. Go to new. Okay, once you press new, they give you these project settings. So normally I will set it as 1080p, 30 frames per second. It's quite standard. I'm not going to do any changes. So click OK. I'm going to briefly walk you through the user interface. On the left hand side, this is a media and control panel. This is where you import your video, music, and overlay. There's a control button here as well. You can use it to make some basic adjustments to your video. This is the trimmer in the middle, where we can trim your video clip before putting it into the editor timeline. This is the editor timeline panel, where actions are happening. The clips that came down here will appear in your final video. This is the viewer. Viewer will display videos on the editor timeline or wherever you place your playhead. This is the effects panel, where you can choose and apply visual or audio effects that the software has to offer. This is the audio meter, where you can monitor and adjust audio level whenever necessary. I really like this user interface a lot. It is very user-friendly, intuitive, and easy to use. I can further customize it based on my own preference. For example, I don't use trimmer and audio meter that much. So I just go to workspace, turn off audio meter, turn off trimmer, and turn off this one. Now, as you can see, there's only 4 panels left on my screen. I can also adjust the panel size by just click and drag along. First thing, go to the media panel, press the import button, select all the clips you're going to work with, in this case all of this, click open. Click the first clip they're going to use, in this case my son here, and then I'm going to select another clip, just Kung Fu Panda clip, I'm going to put side by side. Okay, what I'm trying to achieve is trying to sync up the movie with my son's imitating Tai Lung. And this clip is a little bit odd size, so I'm going to right click, go to transform, and you can see here this fit to frame width, so this looks much better now, isn't it? I'm going to drag all the way where Tai Lung started talking. Where is the Dragon Warrior? Okay, here, somewhere here, you can see the waveform that indicates from silent to the time when he started talking. You can expand it by pulling the slider here. Right, you can see. So this wave coming up here. That's when he started talking. You can also pull it back. Alright, so I'm going to trim this down by doing a simple trick here. As you can see, I move my cursor to the edge here. It showed up a green bracket kind of thing. Just pulled away, all the way here. Right, so that's when he started talking. Where's the Dragon Warrior?
Where's the Dragon Warrior?
Okay, that's neat. I'm trying to match it with my son's talking. So again, you can see if you expand it, you can see the waveform here. I think it's somewhere around here. Yep, that's it. So it's somewhere here. Okay, again, pull the slider all the way left. You can see the Kung Fu Panda one. You're gonna drag it. Oh, sorry. Drag it and put it on top. Right, as you can see, when I pull it up on top, the system automatically generated a second track, which is called Video 2. I'm gonna rename it to Kung Fu Panda, right? If it doesn't automatically appear, all you need to do is you go to video 1, right click, and then insert track. That's going to create a second track as well. Alright.
Where's the Dragon Warrior?
It synced up nicely. So what you're going to do is you're going to reduce the size of the movie clip by clicking this one, go to control, and under the transform button, as you can see, scale 16.6, because I think this one is shoot at a larger format. I'm going to reduce it to say 6%. Right, this is much better now, isn't it? So I'm just going to move this on the right corner. Right, so that's our first clip. I'm going to trim down the ending part here, the remaining part which I don't need. Go to the size tool, click on the line here, go back to the hand tool, or rather what's this called, the selection tool, click on this clip, just press delete or control X. Next, I'm going to pull my second clip here. Okay, the format doesn't look like right because this was shot in 2007 when my son was 2 years old. So I'm going to fit it to height. Back then, all the formats are 4x3. So you need to fit it to height. I'm going to move it to somewhere around here. Probably, yeah, around this here. I'm going to trim it. That's the hilarious part. I'm going to trim it again. Now, as you can see, there's a big gap between these two clips. Fret not. Put your cursor in between the gap and then right click. Go to Ripple Delete Gap and click. Right. That will automatically connect these two clips. Moving all the thing on the right, all the clips on the right, to the left. And next, I'm going to put in an overlay. This is called a camcoder overlay. I'm going to put a link in the description below to show you where to download it. Right. So that's how it looks. And then I'm going to drag it on top. Right, but you can't see the video below. But fret not. Just right click on this clip, go to blend, and choose the screen mode. Voila. Now it looks good, very good, isn't it? Just trim this all the way. Now you have this effect. Okay, next, I'm just going to temporarily switch off this video by clicking the I button here. Right, because I'm going to work on these two parts, the date and the time, just to make it more realistic, as though I was really using a camcorder to film it back then. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this A here, okay? Then I'm going to drag it. Alright, then I'm going to put in a date. It's October 07. Alright, this is not the right size, so I'm just going to trim it down. Either by doing here, reduce the font size, or just go to control. This is my favorite method. Just reduce it down. I'm going to use this position tool to position it. You just need to pull left and right to reduce the size. I need to line these two up. Alright. Just click the eye so that you can see it. Right. So in the interest of time, I'm not going to show you how to do the time. It's exactly the same thing. Just stack it on top, put another text, and then write the time. Insert track and call it lower third. Just pull it down. Let's take a look. In the next video, I'm going to share with you where to download all this lower third, and also going to leave a link in the description below on how to create a lower third like this, how to customize it, because this itself is a big topic and someone else have already done a video on that, so I'm not going to spend my time on that. For the next clip, I'm going to work with an image. Just going to drag it here. And I'm going to change the duration to 3 seconds. Right, for this particular effect, which is known as the ink transition effect, I need to work it through a composite shot. Let's call this ink transition. A composite shot is basically a workplace where you have to work on a more complicated effects, where you can't do it on the editor timeline. But in any point in time, if you want to go back to editor, just click on this button and you go back here, right? So just go back to the in transition composite shot. I'm going to pull in my transition effect and pull it on top of our video clip here, right? For this particular transition effect, I'm going to share with you in my next video where to download it. It's totally free. And so be sure to check out the next video. For this effect, I'm going to select set mat effect, set mat, and then pull this effect to the image. Alright, and I'm going to, for the source layer, I'm going to follow the paint transition, or the ink transition. Click on the eye button on the effects, see how it goes. Now it looks pretty good, isn't it? Okay, now let's do the last step. I'm going to drag the photo here again. I'm going to pull in the snow effect. Okay, let's change the duration to around 3 seconds. And then, I'm going to lay it on top here, somewhere around here. Let's change the blend mode to screen again. Let's see how it looks. I'm going to create a track after audio 2, insert track, and then rename the track to music. Okay, this is the one that I've downloaded earlier. I'm just going to pull it down here. This audio mixer here, just click it. Alright, this audio mixer, you can trim down the size. The one that I'm interested on is the relative strength between audio 3 and audio 1. And let's see how it looks. Looking at her. Right, and audio 2 is consistently lower than audio 1, which is good. But the music one seems to overpower all of this. Yeah. So it really depends on what you want. For example, if you want to emphasize the video 1, which is my son's speech, perhaps I need to reduce the music volume as well to, let's say, -6, and then see how it goes.
How do you know you're not looking at her?
Before I call it a day, I just want to add in another effect, which is quite common for all videos for editing software. And this is available in Hitfilm Express as well. You go to the effect panel, move all the way down under transition video, dissolve, choose cross dissolve. I'm going to put it at the beginning of the video. Just pull and drag. You can see this green color thing here. What it does is that it's going to slowly emerge from black into the video, right? If you put it at the end, then it's going to slowly reduce to black. And then in between clip, you can also put it so that it will cross dissolve from one clip to another. Let's take a look. Okay. To render the video, go to export, click this button here, export now, click into out area. The system will automatically start rendering the video.
How do you know you're not looking at her?
If you have come this far, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. If you like the video, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell button so that you will not miss out any future content. Please leave me a comment down in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about this video, what you would like to see more, and how I can improve in my future videos. Please make sure that you check out my another video up at the link above. That's where I'm going to share with you where I download all the free stock footages and high quality overlays that were used throughout the entire video. Thanks for watching again. This is the end of the video. I'm going to see you on my next one.